Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you all are doing great. Today's video is a video which I have been trying to film 3-4 times. I think this entire giant I was trying to film it 3-4 times, but whenever I used to start, I couldn't finish the video. So this is my fifth time trying this video. So I hope I'll complete this video in this one go. So without any further delay, let me tell you the topic. It's about my 2017 makeup favorites. So these are my most favorite used products for the year 2017. So the first favorite product is this primer. This is from the brand L'Oreal. It's L'Oreal Magic Lumini Light Infused Primer. I have used this primer even if I don't put any makeup. It really gives some shine and glow to my face, which is very subtle as well. Most of the times I have used this primer by mixing it into my foundation, mixing it in my concealer, and also I use this primer as my base and put only powder as well, even on all the three cases. It really looks very nice, and I really like the finish of this primer, and whatever I apply on this, it really stays for a long time as well. Next, we'll talk about foundations. I really like these two foundations for the year 2017. This is from L'Oreal. It's L'Oreal True Match Lumini Healthy Luminous Makeup Foundation. It is having SPF 20 in it. I'm in the shade N78 Classic Tan. Combination of these two are really good. It really gives you a nice finish, and also it keeps your face hydrated as well. If you have a dry skin, I really ask you to try this product at least once, either of these, and it is a very nice alternative from drugstore. The next foundation is this LA Girl Pro Coverage HD High Definition Longwear Illuminating Foundation. This is a very nice drugstore alternative for I don't remember which brand it is. Try to include it when I'm editing it. This gives a very nice illuminating effect. This is a very light shade for me, so I try to mix it up with my other foundations, or else I have tried to use this as my concealer and highlight. So this gives very nice finish as well to your face, and this can be doubled up and layered also, but it never felt any cakiness. I have a dry skin, so I use all illuminating or hydrating kind of products on my skin. The next one is a concealer. This is from Maybelline Fit Me. It's in the shade 30 Cafe. I use this concealer to hide my under eye dark circles, hyperpigmentation areas, and other places where I have some kind of spots. And on top of it, I use some powder, and it really gives me very natural finish. It doesn't look like I have too much product on my face, and at the same time, it looks a little okay for me, because I have I have very high dark circles and hyperpigmentation areas, so if I don't use any corrector, they really look out very well. But whenever I use this, it at least hides them very little. This is not a high coverage, but I really like this for day-to-day use, and I even don't like a high coverage concealers or hyperpigment, like a product which covers your skin. So for me, this is really nice concealer. I used only this concealer for entire 2017. The next thing is this Anastasia Beverly Hills corrector. I got it in the shade Keshe Creams 40. This is not too orange or not too yellowish, so sometimes I use this as my corrector, and sometimes I use this as my highlighter. I know using corrector as a highlighter is not recommended, or it may look orangey, but for me, it once it settles down on my skin and I put some powder on top of it, it doesn't look orangish at all. Because I really bought very light orange shade, that's the reason I use this as my highlight as well. But right now I stopped using this as my highlighter. I'm just using this as my corrector. I feel using this as corrector helps worked out well for me. So that's about this. The next favorite is this e.l.f. powder. This is e.l.f. finishing powder in the shade light medium. I use this powder on my day-to-day basis. So this is how the shade looks like. I did not find the dark shade, so that's the reason I got this shade. So whenever I use this to under my dark circles and on my hyperpigmentation areas, or on my day-to-day basis, whenever I don't put any makeup also, it really gives me the natural finish. It doesn't have much coverage, but this is how it looks. makes your skin look a little smooth and finished. So whenever I use this, I use any of the setting spray so that it doesn't settles into my dry areas, because I have dry skin. So setting spray and this powder are really good combination for me, a go-to combination for me. So that's about this powder. Next, coming to the setting sprays, I have used these two setting sprays in the last year, and also I have used Urban Decay setting spray, but I got it in the little end of the year, like October, November. So these are my highly used setting sprays for the year 2017. This is from e.l.f. This is e.l.f. Makeup Mist and Setting Spray. This is a nice drugstore alternative. And this is from MAC. This is MAC Prep and Prime. I really like this setting spray. It really keeps your makeup in place, and also you can use this as a how I use this setting spray is, like, before applying any makeup, I used to put on this spray, and once I put on my foundation, I used to spray so that the foundation sets in place, and once I put my entire makeup, I use this, so it keeps the entire makeup in place for a long time. That's how I use any of the setting sprays. But in general, I don't show it in my videos because it goes a very long, the video becomes very long. That's the reason I use this only at the end of my videos. But in day-to-day life, that's how I use this setting spray. And recently they got many variants in this MAC Prep and Prime, and I'm really eager to try those. I saw those travel size versions in Nordstrom and also in Macy's, but I'm not getting time to go to store and buy. But if I want to do any online purchase, they have some minimum purchase, like $100 in Nordstrom rack. So I don't want to spend $100 online. That's the reason I'm just waiting for a moment to go to the store and get those three. I'm not sure if they're still available, but during the time of Thanksgiving and December and the start of January, I have seen those. So that's about this setting spray. The next thing is this Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contour Palette. I'm in the shade Caramel Toffee. These are the two shades. This is a banana color and this is a nice contour shade. This powder works wonder. This is really, really very smooth powder, and it gives, whenever you apply it, it really highlights your under eyes or the area where you set and gives you a nice finish. And this is a correct contour shade in drugstore, which I have found for my shade, because every time I find it to be either light or too dark. But this is the nice contour shade. This is how it looks. This is little powdery, but once you tap off the excess on your brush, it really works nice. And Avian was playing this one day, so here I got a crack and I lost the product. Next, coming to blush, I'm not a blush person in general, so whenever it comes to blushes, I have only 2 to 3 blushes at most. So in 2017, I really enjoyed using this Essence Satin Touch Blush in the shade Satin Coral. This is how the shade looks like. This is a nice corally shade, and I can use this as my eyeshadow shade as well. This is how it looks. This goes nice with everyday makeup, high makeup, and if you do a good eye makeup also, this really blends well into my skin type. Next blush is from the Balm. This is Balm Springs Long Wearing Blush. This is in the shade where can I find the shade? I'm not sure what shade it is, but this is how the blush looks like. I got this blush in my Ipsy bag, and this is also a kind of corally shade. That's the reason I like this. If you see, these two are almost same. The Essence, this is the Essence blush, and this is the Balm blush. But Balm blush has more pinky undertones to it. Coming to lashes, I really have these two favorites. One is from L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise Mascara. This is one of the absolute favorite from L'Oreal. If you want to try anything from drugstore and which is affordable, this is one of the good option, because this gives both length and volume. The only backdrop for this is it really dries up very fast. Maybe 1-1.5 month it dries up. So you have to keep buying the new one every 1 to 1.5 month, or else you have to finish up the product very soon. I think this is my third bottle of this L'Oreal mascara. I really, really enjoyed using each and every the product. That's about this mascara. The next favorite is this It Cosmetics Superhero Mascara. It really gives a very nice length to my lashes, and also I really like to apply this on my bottom lashes as well. I don't like to apply mascara to my bottom lashes because I'm really lazy to remove mascara, because you have to put little effort to it. So very, very less times I prefer doing this lower lashes mascara. So this is one of the high-end favorite mascara which I liked. Coming to brows, I really like these two products. This is L'Oreal Brow Stylish Definer. This is a brow styler definer pencil. I'm in the shade Dark Brunette. I'm almost done with the product. So it has a spoolie and it has a product. I really like if they have some black color, because dark brunette is little light for me, and most of the times I really like to put my eyebrows little light, because if it is more dark, I don't think it will suit to me. But in today's look, I was trying a black eyeshadow. The next product is this Essence Make Me Brow Eyebrow Gel Mascara. If you are in a hurry and if you don't have much time to do your eyebrows, if you use this only brow mascara, it really keeps your brows in place, and it also adds some shine. I really want them to bring one color in black as well, so that it really works well on dark skin tones as well with black hair. I think I'm in the shade, Brownie Bronze. So this is the shade 02 Brownie Bronze. One kajal which I have used the entire last year is this Pixie kajal. This is Pixie Endless Silky Eye Pen. I'm in general not an kajal person, but I don't know, from last year I'm really liking kajals a lot, because if you are having a dull face, it really pops up, kajal pops up on your face. That's what I have observed last year, and this is a really nice textured pen as well, and I got this in my Ipsy bag. So that's about this. To the lips, I'm a really lipstick person. Even if I don't have any makeup, I really like to put something on my lips. That is how I am. So when the topic comes to choose one lipstick, or I cannot pick one product or one lipstick. So here I got few of them. I totally have 5 liquid lipsticks or lipsticks. So the first one is this L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Liquid Lipstick. This is the lipstick which I am wearing now. I am in the shade 366 Stirred. So this is how Stirred looks like. If you want to know more details about these liquid lipsticks which I'm going to talk, I have made few videos on them, so I'll link them in the I button and also put them in the description bar below. If you are really interested to know more details about these liquid lipsticks, please check those videos. And the next thing is this Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink. I'm in the shade 40 Believer. The next thing is this ColourPop Ultra Satin. This is in the shade Barbecue. So this is how it looks. After using this liquid lipstick, I'm totally into mauve shades. I'm not in general a person who likes pinks or mauves, because I feel like they don't suit me, but using this liquid lipstick, I'm more gravitated towards this kind of lip shade. So I'm trying this year, most of the times I'll try these kind of shades. The next line is this Wet n Wild. This is Wet n Wild Mega Last Liquid Catsuit Liquid Lipstick. This is in the shade 925B Give Me Mocha. I have few other liquid lipsticks in this range. This is a very nice drugstore alternative for the liquid lipsticks, because it's under $6 and it also stays for a long time. And I really like the formulation, and this is a cruelty free brand. So even ColourPop is a cruelty free brand, and Wet n Wild is a cruelty free brand. These days I'm trying to see more of cruelty free products, and I want to include those in my makeup. But right now what all I have, I want to finish them, and then I want to jump into the cruelty free products. Next thing is this MAC matte lipstick. I'm in the shade Russian Red. So this is my first MAC lipstick. I never tried MAC lipsticks. So this is how the shade looks like. It has a vanilla flavor to it. So if you are using any of these liquid lipsticks or matte lips, try to exfoliate your lips so that they stay long, and also they doesn't make your lips very chappy. So that's about this lipsticks. Finally did this video and I'm feeling very happy because I cannot express in words, because it's my fifth time trying this and I have finally done this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you all like this video. If you do so, please hit on the like button and also subscribe back to my channel. I'll catch you guys in my next video. Until then, be positive and stay happy. Bye.